Namaste to everyone. It's me, Manisha Mahara, one of the science teacher of UVMC 3, 4 and 5. Today I'm here to discuss about various basic terms of science. Dear students, at first we'll discuss about herbivores. Students, do you know what is herbivores? Yes, plants eating animals are known as herbivores, or we can say those animals that eat plants or plants products such as grass, branches, fruits, flowers, grains, these animals are known as herbivores. I'll give you some examples. You can say goat. What does goat eat? Goat eat grass or grass products. So we can say goat is a herbivore animal. I'll give you another example. Cow. Have you seen cow? Yes, you must have seen cow in your houses. What does it eat? It eat grasses. So students, we can say those animals that eat plants or plants product are called herbivores or herbivorous animals. From this definition, we are clear that those animals that eat grass or plants products such as hay, fruit, flower, grains, those animals are known as herbivorous animals. And the examples are cow, goat, buffalo, ox, etc. Now moving towards another topic, it is carnivores. Friends, do you know what carnivores are? Yeah, you have read in previous chapter what carnivorous animals are. Carnivorous animals are those animals that eat flesh or meat. You can say flesh or meat. Those animals that eat flesh or meat. I'll give example: lion, tiger, wolf. Friends, do you know what do these animals eat? Yes, these animals eat flesh, or you can say meat. So we can say that those animals that eat flesh or meat, these animals are known as carnivorous animals. I'll give you definition also. You can copy on your notebook. Those animals that eat only flesh. They eat only flesh. They do not eat grass or plants. That eat only flesh are known as carnivores, or you can say carnivorous animals. And the examples are lion, tiger, wolf. They eat the flesh of another animal. Now moving towards next topic, it is also similar topic, omnivores. Student, do you know what are omnivorous animals? Yes, you know that what omnivorous animals are, as you have read in your previous classes. I'll give examples such as we, human beings, dog. What do we eat? We eat both plants and animals, such as in the case of flesh, we eat chicken, mutton, fish. This is known as flesh of other animals. And for plant product, we eat grains, vegetables, fruits. These are plant product. So what do we eat? We eat both flesh and plants. So you can note in your note copy. Those animals that eat both flesh and plants are called omnivores, or omnivorous animals. And the examples are human beings, cat, dog, etc. I hope you have understood what herbivorous animals are, carnivorous animals are, and omnivorous animals are. Now moving towards next topic, it is food chain. So student, do you know what food chain is? Okay, if you don't know, I'll tell you. First, I'll explain you by giving an example. What is this? Grains. Who eat grains? Birds. Who eat birds? Snake or big bird, we can say. Okay. The energy stored in grain. When the bird eat grain, the energy stored in grain is transferred to bird. So who is getting the energy? Bird. Now, next, when the snake eat bird, the energy stored in bird is again transferred to snake. So the energy of grain is transferred to birds, and similarly the energy of bird is transferred to snake. So by this example we can say that the transfer of energy from one organism to another organism through food is known as food chain. Have you understood it? I'll give you another example. Okay. Grass. Grass is eaten by deer. And the deer is eaten by lion. And the lion, after some time, it die. Or we can say it decompose. It decompose. And it produce new plants. Okay, here, when deer eat grass, the energy, the food that grass have, or the nutrients grass have, it is transferred to deer. When similarly the lion eats deer, the energy stored in deer is transferred to lion. And similarly, when it die, it decompose, yani sorcer, vulture, and that dead body changes into nutrients and it produces new plants. And similarly, new plant, it grow into grass or another plant products, and it is eaten by another animal. Then that animal is eaten by another animal. This chain is known as food chain. Friends, I hope now it is clear to you what food chain is. Now I'll write the definition, you can note. Say that the transfer of energy from one organism to another organism through food. Through the medium of food, the energy is transferred. Through food is called food chain. Dear students, here the organism does not denote only animal, it also denotes plants, such as we said grass, grain. I hope you have understood this. Now our next topic is condensation. Before explaining this topic, I want to tell you that can you blow in your hand, blow air on your hand for 10 seconds. What do you feel? You feel that your hand is damp or halka bhigeko jasto tapaiharule mahsus huncha. Yeah, what is this? This process is condensation. When gas or steam, or we can say water vapor. When gas, steam or water vapor comes in contact with cold or cool object, it changes into water or water droplets. This process is known as condensation. I'll give you another example. Have you seen boiling water? When the water is boiling and when you cover the lid, ढक्कनले छोप्नु हुन्छ, बिर्काले बिर्कोले छोप्नु हुन्छ, what do you feel? There is tiny droplets of water on the lid. Yes, this process is known as condensation. I'll give you another example. When you blow air on the mirror, what do you see? You see tiny droplets of water on the mirror. Yes, this process is also known as condensation. Now, I'll write the definition. The process of changing water vapor into water on cooling is called condensation. I hope you have understood this topic. Now moving towards another topic, it is melting. Before melting, I again want to ask you one question. Have you seen burning candle? Yes, you might have seen. What happens when we burn that candle? Yes, when we burn the candle starts melting. This process is known as melting. Or we can say in similar word, the process of changing solid into water, liquid on heating is called melting. Here, the process of changing solid, that candle, which I have given example, yes, candle is in solid state. When we give it heat, it changes into liquid. So this process is known as melting. I'll give you another example. Ice cream. The ice cream we eat, it is also in solid state. When we give heat or when we keep ice cream for a minute in the sun, it starts melting. So we can say what melting is. Hope you have understood this topic. Now moving towards another topic. Freezing, just opposite of melting. Okay, students, do you know what freezing is? By the word, you can say what freezing is. Freezing, freeze, to freeze something, to make solid. Okay, when you keep water on refrigerator for an hour, for half an hour, what does it change? That water changes into ice. When we keep water in a fridge, freeze means when we cool water, it changes into ice. Water is in liquid state and ice is in solid state. This process is known as freezing. The process of changing liquid into solid by cooling is known as freezing. I'll give you the definition. You can note in your note copy. The process of changing liquid into solid on cooling it or freezing. My dear students, I hope you have understood these 7 topics. What herbivores animals are, what carnivores animals are, what are omnivores, what do you mean by food chain, what is condensation, what is melting, and what is freezing. Dear students, before we have discussed about 7 topics, herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, condensation, freezing, melting, and food chain. Now, more 6 points are left, or you can say 6 terms are left. Now, we're gonna discuss about vertebrate. I have written the definition here, so you can look at the definition. I'll write the example on whiteboard. First, we'll go through the definition what vertebrate animals are. Students, those animals that have backbone on their body is called vertebrate. Animals having backbone on their bodies are called vertebrate. I'll show you where our backbone is located. Strength, can you see this skeleton? Yes, this is the backbone of a human body, or you can say spine. It starts from our neck to the waist, or you can say pelvic bone. This is our backbone. It supports our body and helps to stand straight. Now, moving towards next topic, it is invertebrate. Now, next topic is invertebrate. Vertebrates animals such as we human beings, or we can say man, dog, etc. These animals or these organisms have backbone. Now, moving towards next topic, invertebrate. Invertebrates are those animals that do not have backbone on their bodies are called invertebrate. Students, I have already shown where our backbone is located. So, animals that do not have these backbones are known as invertebrates animals. I'll give you example. Example of invertebrate animals are earthworm, snail, etc. These animals do not have backbone. I hope you have understood what vertebrate and what invertebrates animal are. Now, moving towards next topic, stomata. Do you know what stomata is? Yes, you know. Stomata is the breathing organ of plant, or we can say the small pores present on the surface of leaf through which plants breathe is called stomata. You have seen leaves. Have you seen leaves? Yes. When you see the leaves, you can see small pores on the leaves. These small pores are known as stomata. This stomata helps to breathe or excrete or remove excess water from the parts of plant. Now, next topic is photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is the process by which green plants prepare their food using air, water, and sunlight. If any one of these, air, water, or sunlight is missing, plants cannot prepare their food. While preparing food, these plants should contain air, water, and sunlight. And one most important thing, only green plants prepare food. Non-green plants cannot prepare their own food. Now, moving towards next topic, chlorophyll. What do you mean by chlorophyll? Chlorophyll is the green pigment. Chlorophyll is the green pigment present on the leaves. Chlorophyll is present on the leaf. That's why we can see the leaves of most of the plants are green. It is due to the presence of chlorophyll. The plants that contain chlorophyll can only prepare food. So we can say that the green pigment present in the leaves is called chlorophyll. Now last but not the least, evaporation. It is the process of changing liquid. Process of changing liquid into gas on heating. When we heat liquid, I'll give example. When we heat liquid such as water, when we boil water, it changes into water vapor. Water vapor, or you can say steam or gas. When we heat water, it changes into water vapor or steam or gas. This process is known as evaporation. I have given the definition on the chart paper. The process of changing liquid into gas on heating is called evaporation. And the example you have seen here, when we heat water, it changes into gas or water vapor. Friends, we have completed 13 terms in this episode. We are gonna learn more terms in next episode. Now, I want to give you homework. You can note on your copy. Your homework is find out your homework. Find out 13 terms apart from these. And apart from these. Okay, students, you have to write 13 terms apart from these which today I have taught you. Today which we have discussed. You have to find 13 more terms from your book and write on your fake copy. And when the school will open, you have to show this to your subject teacher. We are gonna learn more in next episode. Thank you.